జనగణమన అధినాయక జయ హే భారత భాగ్య విధాత పంజాబ సింధ గుజరాత మరాఠా ద్రావిడ ఉత్కళ వంగా వింధ్య హిమాచల యమునా గంగా ఉచ్చల జగది తరంగా తవ శుభ నామే జాగే తవ శుభ ఆశిష మాగే గాహే తవ జయ గాథా జనగణ మంగళదాయక జయ హే భారత భాగ్య విధాతా జయ హే జయ హే జయ హే జయ 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 హే
Namaskaram and Suswagatam. A very good morning, everybody. It gives me, Manasi, immense delight in extending a hearty welcome to all of you, especially the honorable guests seated on the dais and all you invitees seated in the audience assembled in this historical international convention hall of BSE, which earlier used to be the trading ring, for this very, very special event. Listing of Amravati Bond 2018 by the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu. The Honorable guests and esteemed dignitaries on the dais will be welcomed with bouquets of flowers. Kindly accept them as token of love and appreciation. Beginning with the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu, please accept these flowers as a token of respect and gratitude. Sri Yanamala Ramakrishna Du Garu, Honorable Minister for Finance and Planning, Commercial Taxes and Legislative Affairs, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Dr. P. Narayana Garu, Honorable Minister for Municipal Administration and Urban Development and Urban Housing, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Shri C. Kutumba Rao Garu, Vice Chairman, Planning Board, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Shri Satish Chandra, Special Chief Secretary, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Shri Ajay Jain Garu, Principal Secretary to Government of Energy, Infrastructure and Investment and CRDA Departments, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Dr. Sridhar Cherukuri Garu, Commissioner, Andhra Pradesh Capital Region Development Authority. And Shri J. Krishna Kishore Garu, Chief Executive Officer, Andhra Pradesh Economic Development Board, Secretary to Government. I would also request you, sir, to please present the coffee table books of BSE to all the honorable guests and dignitaries seated on the dais. MD and CEO of BSE, Sri Ashish Kumar Chauhan, will now present coffee table books on BSE. Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu, Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, has accepted this coffee table book. Sri Yanamala Ramakrishna Du Garu, Honorable Minister for Finance and Planning, Commercial Taxes and Legislative Affairs, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Dr. P. Narayana Garu, Honorable Minister for Municipal Administration and Urban Development and Urban Housing, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Shri C. Kutumba Rao Garu, Vice Chairman, Planning Board, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Shri Satish Chandra Garu, Special Chief Secretary, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Shri Ajay Jain Garu, Principal Secretary to Government, Energy, Infrastructure and Investment and CRDA Department, Government of Andhra Pradesh. Dr. Sridhar Cherukuru Garu, Commissioner, Andhra Pradesh Capital Region Development Authority. And Shri J. Krishna Kishore Garu, Chief Executive Officer, Andhra Pradesh Economic Development Board, Secretary to Government. In keeping with the Indian tradition, the inauguration will now be done by lighting the auspicious ceremonial lamp. I request the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh and other esteemed dignitaries on the dais to kindly step down for lighting the lamp. Deepena Lokana Jayati, Deepastejo Mayaha Smritaha, Chaturvarga Pradodipan, Tasmat Deep Yajet Priye. This couplet in Sanskrit translates, "The lamp is luminous, its radiance grants victory, its light imparts dharma, artha, kama and moksha, that is righteousness, prosperity, pleasure and finally emancipation." The Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Narachandra Babu Naidu Garu, lighting the lamp along with Sri Yanamala Ramakrishnudu Garu, Honorable Minister for Finance and Planning, Commercial Taxes and Legislative Affairs, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Dr. P. Narayana Garu, Honorable Minister for Municipal Administration and Urban Development and Urban Housing, Government of Andhra Pradesh, all other officials of the Government of Andhra Pradesh, and of course we have MD CEO of BSE, Sri Ashish Kumar Chauhan, doing the honors. Ladies and gentlemen, some moments to be treasured in the form of pictures. The lamp being lit, the function has been inaugurated. Lamp, as we all know, is also a symbol of knowledge. And now, the momentous time for which we were eagerly waiting has finally arrived. It is almost arriving. 9:15 is the time. At the sharp moment, we will be ringing the gong at 9:15. It is 9:12 now. We have a couple of more moments to go. In the meanwhile, I will just draw your attention to the fact that Amaravati, the people's capital of Andhra Pradesh, following hugely successful land pooling scheme, wherein 33,000 acres of land is voluntarily handed over for development of the capital city by over 27,000 land owners in a record 60 days time during early 2015. The master plan was notified in February 2016 with support from Government of Singapore. Designed on sustainability and happy city principles, Amaravati will have 30% of blue and green coverage, a 5, 10, 15 based development model wherein all emergency facilities are within 5-minute public community and recreational facilities are in 10-minute distance and work facilities are in 15-minute distance. It is 9:13. The Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh and other dignitaries have proceeded for the ringing of the gong, which will mark the official listing of the Amaravati Bond 2018 on the BSE platform. When the timer strikes 10 seconds, you all will join me in putting your hands together when the countdown finally begins, when it is just 10 seconds to go. It will truly be an honor to be introduced and welcomed on the BSE platform for the Government of Andhra Pradesh, its investors and stakeholders of the Amaravati Bond 2018. It is 45 seconds more. Amaravati is the economic powerhouse and there are many development plans to give impetus to its economy, the state as a whole. Few more pictures. memories to be treasured, and we are almost there. Let us begin the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Congratulations! The infrastructure of Amaravati is designed and received, reviewed. So the applause also has to be louder. The excitement was such that I believe your clap and the ringing of the gong has directly reached the people of Amaravati. Thank you so very much. Request you all to kindly occupy your seats while I call upon Sri Ashish Kumar Chauhan, MD and CEO BSE, to address this august gathering on this absolutely joyous and extremely significant occasion. Sir.
Respected Sri N. Chandra Babu Naidu, Chief Minister Andhra Pradesh, Sri Yanmala Ramakrishnadu, Minister of Finance and Planning, Commercial Taxes and Legislative Affairs, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Dr. P. Narayana, Minister of Municipal Administration and Urban Development and Housing, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Kutumba Rao, Vice Chairman, Planning Board, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Ajay Jain, IAS, Principal Secretary, Energy Infrastructure, Investments and CRDO Departments, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri M. Ravichandra, IAS, Principal Secretary, Finance, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Dr. Sridhar Cherukari, IAS, Commissioner Andhra Pradesh, Capital Region Development Authority. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning and a warm welcome to everyone to the iconic Firoz Gigi Bhai Towers, which has secured a trademark and now is a part of an elite club of distinguished structures around the world. On behalf of BSE, I would like to wholeheartedly express my deepest appreciation and profound gratitude towards respected Honorable Chief Minister Sri Chandra Babu Naidu Garu for gracing the occasion as a chief guest for listing of the Amaravati Municipal Bonds. Sir, we are deeply honored to have you here. Sir, under your leadership, the state of Andhra Pradesh has consistently ranked number one the last 3 years on the ease of doing business index among states and emerge as a leader in manufacturing and information technology. We also received feedback from investors that your state has been consistently assuring investors about predictability in politics. Sir, I believe that the state capital of Amaravati, when fully constructed, is expected to be the most technology compatible city in India, which is at one with the nature. The people of Andhra Pradesh and the people of India are looking forward to that. I congratulate the state government under the leadership of Chief Minister Sri Chandra Babu Naidu for both planning and executing the ambitious projects. The state has lived up to its well-deserved reputation for not only being an innovator in technology adoption, but also in raising funds for building the capital city. Sir, BSE is proud to contribute, albeit in a small way, in your endeavor to build a world-class capital city, which reflects our traditions rooted in our ancient culture and at the same time showcases our world-class aspirations. India's urban infrastructure is reeling under the immense pressure of the growth that the country is witnessing. While agencies have estimated varying amount of money required in infrastructure build-out, one aspect is common, funding of a large magnitude. According to a recently released economic survey for 2018, India will face a US$526 billion infrastructure investment gap by 2040, which works out to roughly US$25 billion per year till 2040. The survey says the collapse of public-private partnership, stress balance sheets of private firms, and problems with clearances are main reasons behind infrastructure investment shortfalls. A robust municipal bond market is the answer to bridging this shortfall and thus building urban India in a smart way. Municipal bonds are the ideal instruments for raising resources into infrastructure development. Historical data with BSE shows that during the decades of 1960s and 1970s, utilities with Pune and Mumbai municipal corporations issued bonds spread over various tenures from 5 to 10 years. Even though it was dormant, some 25 urban bodies have raised money since the first municipal bond issue by Ahmedabad in 1998. The new municipal bond regulations released by the Securities and Exchange Board of India in 2016, which deals with many of the problems related to municipal bonds, has brought a fresh lease of life. In 2017, Pune added a new chapter in the country's urban transformation saga based on Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi's vision of financially empowering urban local bodies. BSE firmly believes that Indian bond market is poised for a substantial growth, and India can use its domestic savings to fund its infrastructure needs in a substantial manner. I'm also delighted to inform you that under the leadership of SEBI, many such new investments are listed within a short span of time, giving investors a wide choice of asset classes. Sir, as you are aware, the Amravati bonds 2018 for raising 2,000 crores issued by Andhra Pradesh Capital Region Development Authority, CRDA, was subscribed 1.5 times on the electronic bidding platform of BSE, called BSE Bonds, in less than 1 hour, sir. On August 14, one day before our Independence Day, and now we are gathered here, one day after Raksha Bandhan, Nareli Purnima, which is a very auspicious day for the entire India. This response shows the faith the investors have reposed in not only Andhra Pradesh government and also the Chief Minister, but also the state of the art, robust and efficient infrastructure offered by Andhra Pradesh government. BSE also provides an efficient and transparent market for trading in a bouquet of products like equity, debt, currencies, interest rate derivatives, mutual funds, stock lending, borrowing, and many more. Today, BSE has over 5,000 listed companies on its platforms, making it the largest of any exchange in the world. BSE has played a prominent role in developing the Indian capital markets. It's Asia's first and then the fastest stock exchange in the world with a speed of 6 microseconds. BSE has kept pace with the latest in technology. BSE puts forward a strong, robust platform for investors to trade in a highly secure and reliable environment that offers enhanced liquidity, diversity of participants, innovative technology, and trustworthy clearing services. We are making a history in this hall today, where the brokers used to trade with hand signals, and today, after BSE became completely automated, it has been converted into an international convention hall. So, sir, thank you for coming here. BSE is emerging as a preferred investment destination, with the exchange facilitating investments in priority sectors such as mutual funds, SMEs, and also the small little companies specified in incubators. To encourage the SMEs from Andhra Pradesh, through the medium of SME listings, we recommend that the state, as a way of encouragement, sir, can contribute up to 1 crore rupees or 15% of the issue size, whichever is lower, so that the companies from Andhra Pradesh, SME companies from Andhra Pradesh, start listing on stock exchanges, so that and the money which you raise or which you have paid off up to 1 crore can actually later on be sold in the same market like BSE. And that money can be recirculated to fund other companies. So you don't have to give subsidies. Instead, you invest in the equity of the company when the company comes out with an IPO, so you know that you have an exit route. Otherwise, the subsidies never come back, and you don't know what happens to subsidies here. Whatever money you are putting in is actually available to you, their value, transparently. And after 1 or 2 years, you can actually sell the stake which you have taken in the company. Till now, BSE has listed 260 companies, SME, and we have raised more than 2,500 crore rupees for SMEs, but those companies now are valued at close to 25,000 crore rupees. So BSE is helping SMEs to grow, raise funds for them, but also help industrialize the country. The BSE would like to make a formal proposal to your good self, sir, today while we meet later on. And as and when required, we'll come and sign an MOU in Amravati. BSE has also been a leader in listing of municipal bonds sovereign gold bonds and green bonds. India INX, a subsidiary of BSE, based in the International Finance Center of GIFT City, Gujarat, raised 600 million bonds issue of Yes Bank, but we have listed more than $22 billion of various midterm notes and masala bonds through the GIFT City Gandhinagar from foreign investors. BSE is taking a lead in bringing international standards in India in technology, compliance, corporate governance, promoting of SMEs, leveraging the exchange platform for mutual funds, insurance, creation of trading of substantial and other indices, including the oldest and most popular index, the S&P BSE Sensex. This will help India to compete with global destinations, making India as one of the foremost financial services market in the world. I promise BSE will continue to provide support to Andhra Pradesh government for all its endeavors. Thank you very much, sir, for coming here today morning.
Thank you, sir, for providing this information, which is a matter of pride for all of us present in this hall this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, I was telling you something about Amravati and a little more now about its infrastructure, which is planned and reviewed by world's renowned architects, engineers and project management consultants, and will have undergone ducts, separate lines for stormwater and sewage, 24/7 treated water supply, uninterrupted quality power supply. The city trunk and layout level infrastructure development is expected to cost around 48,000 crores over the next few years. To tell us more about infrastructure and more, we have the most apt person, Sri Ajay Jain Garu, Principal Secretary to Government, Energy, Infrastructure and Investment, and CRDA Department's Government of Andhra Pradesh. I request you, sir, for your address.
Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu, Honorable Ministers from Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Ashish Kumar Chauhanji, CEO and MD of Bombay Stock Exchange, my colleagues in the Government of Andhra Pradesh, trading partners, investors, staff of BSE, members from the media, dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, on behalf of the Government of Andhra Pradesh, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Bombay Stock Exchange and all the investors and trading partners who are present here for giving us this opportunity for listing of Amravati Bond 2018 in Bombay Stock Exchange, that is the world's fastest exchange. Well, friends, today is a red letter day for the state of Andhra Pradesh in general and its Greenfield People's Capital Amravati in particular in BSE. And that overwhelming response, 1.5 times oversubscription within a period of less than an hour, shows the investors' confidence in the state, the leadership of Mr. Naidu and the new Greenfield capital. Well, friends, the journey of Amravati started in June 2014 when, you know, the combined state of Andhra Pradesh got bifurcated. The capital of Hyderabad, Cyberabad, Secunderabad, the tri-cities which were developed during Mr. Naidu's time as Chief Minister, went to the state of Telangana, and the state of Andhra Pradesh was left with no capital. Even the location was not finalized. But the leader, Mr. Naidu, he saw it as an opportunity rather than a crisis, and he said, gave us a vision of constructing one of the world's best cities. And the location was finalized between Vijayawada and Guntur, which is central to the, as far as Andhra Pradesh is concerned, and it has more than 30 kilometers of riverfront on River Krishna. This is how the location was finalized. And then last 44 months, we have made lot of progress. The first step was, of course, the land. As she mentioned just now, more than 33,000 acres of land was given voluntarily by not one and two, more than 27,000 farmers came forward to pool their land voluntarily and offer to the state government without any upfront payment. And that shows the confidence the people have on its leadership and the new capital. Then the master plan was designed in 217 square kilometers by Sarbana in Jirong. Infrastructure plan was designed by a Chinese firm, and today we have all in place. And we have the Capital Region Development Authority, the CRD area, which is more than 8,000 square kilometers, the Amravati capital of 217 square kilometers, and the seed capital of 6.94 square kilometers. The entire city, we have 9 theme cities, like Government City, Justice City, Tourism City, and 27 townships. Now today as we speak, it is already last 44 months, it is home to the India's best 3 private universities. 2 of them have already started their campuses, they are already into second year, Vellore Institute of Technology and SRM, and Amrita University is going to start its campus from this academic year. It is also to the 2 central premier institutions, National Institute of Design and AIIMS, they have also started their construction work. The administrative complex, which is the High Court, the Assembly and the Government Secretariat and HODs, they have been designed by Foster and Partners, and they are all iconic buildings which you will be seeing in
Ultimately, Amaravati, I want to make a knowledge hub.
Amaravati is the first green capital city of India. The interim government complex today stands as a temple of good governance in the sunrise state of Andhra Pradesh. Amaravati is truly a city that is for the people, by the people, and of the people. That is what makes a people's capital.
With the development of the city, I wanted to bring happiness concept every inch of our development. I need your cooperation for building this city, one of the most happiest city in the world.
So that was Amaravati, the people's capital in a nutshell for all of us, all its attractions and future plans, with huge opportunities to partner in their progress. Ladies and gentlemen, we are indeed very fortunate and highly privileged to have with us this morning the Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Nara Chandrababu Naidu Garu, who also rang the gong and lifted the Amaravati Bond 2018. May I invite you, sir, for your address.
MD, CEO of Bombay Stock Exchange, respected Sri, Ashish Kumar Chauhan, my colleagues, Honorable Minister for Finance, Yarramala Ramakrishnadu, Honorable Minister for Municipal Administration, P. Narayana Garu, my team members, respected leaders in different departments, members of Bombay Stock Exchange, senior leaders from industry, officials from Government of Andhra Pradesh, members of media, ladies and gentlemen. I am very happy just now MD and CEO has rightly mentioned. Today I came here for listing ceremony of Amaravati bonds. He made it very clear. 26th was our Independence Day. 25th they have done here. And at the same time, within 1 hour, we are able to get it nearly 1.5 times to our bond. I am very happy. This is the trust investors are having, this is the trust people are having on Amaravati and government of Andhra Pradesh. You know very well, earlier I developed Hyderabad. Same story at that time. People ask me where is money, and also we used to think traditionally. Even Hyderabad, we didn't have flights also. First flight, I want to have international flight Emirates. At that time, Emirates flights are willing to fly to Hyderabad, but our rules are not permitting. That is the story. I had a very difficult time to convince the then Prime Minister. Then finally he accepted. That is how open sky policy has come. Then we had land, we didn't have water also. At that time World Bank asked me to charge 20 rupees for liter, then only we will finance. Then I decided to go ahead with government expenditure. Within 1 year, I was able to bring water 5 TMs to Hyderabad from Krishna River. That is how we solved the problem of water problem. Then I had a detailed action plan. One is infrastructure. Infrastructure is very crucial for any project. Then I started building infrastructure in Hyderabad. Then I have seen so many airports also. Even Frankfurt, even Dubai, even Singapore, all these airports I have seen. But ultimately, everybody was saying $1 trillion or billion, $1 billion, like that, everybody $3-4 billion. But ultimately, I calculated even less than $1 billion, we can develop a city, cap this airport. That is how first time in India, I request the government of India to finance. They said we don't have money. Then I requested them to accept Greenfield Airport in the first time in India. Then we invited tenders. 5,000 acres of land I have given. That is Hyderabad Airport today. Less than around 2,500 crores or 2,000 crores, we are able to build that airport. Finance is not a problem. Today if you see, that airport alone is bringing or building 15% to 16% of GSTP in Telangana state itself, one airport. That is the strength of airport. Then naturally we have built one of the best outer ring road you have seen. Hyderabad nowhere in the country. That is 161 kilometers outer ring road, 8-lane road I conceived at that time. We borrowed money. Because of that road, Hyderabad is rated one of the best city now. Then Cyberabad we are able to build. All knowledge economy in name any company in the world, they have come. But always one should have vision. And at the same time, to make it a reality, one should market it and execute the project in a big way. That is how, within 9 years' time, we are able to create the city. And ultimately, the city today, with excellent ecosystem, it is moving forward. I am very happy for that. Very rare occasion again. At that time, I built a green brownfield airport, city. Now, destiny forced me to develop greenfield city now. This is another capital. Always, to build a capital is very difficult. To get an opportunity is a rare opportunity. It is a lifetime, even sometimes so many people may not get lifetime opportunity also to build a capital. When I started this capital, generally after bifurcation, you know very well, we are forced to go to Amaravati. Even there is no Amaravati at that time, I named it as Amaravati capital. We don't have land. Then story began. I can explain to you how we have done systematically within 3-4 years time. First 1 year we were in Hyderabad. Then only we started this building, the city. One example I will give you. Two turning points here. I don't have land. One idea. That is land pooling. I told my farmers, you give me land, I will build a capital with the support of Singapore government. Then ultimately, you will get better valuation compared to now. 5 times, 6 times, even 7 times, you will get better value. Then they accepted without paying money. 35,000 acres of land I was able to mobilize. That is the trust this government is having. Then after this land, how to build up, then I went to Singapore. I had earlier connections with Singapore government. That government always believes honesty, integrity, and also values. When I went there, I asked them one thing. I want to build a capital. During elections, I announced, I am going to build another Singapore in India. You help me in building the master plan details. Then I told them I can pay money, but if I call tender, all these procedures will take so much of time. Why can't you do free of cost? They took to the central cabinet within 15 days time. They gave me master plan details, 3 phases. One is, say, Amaravati city, and also Amaravati capital, Amaravati region, all these details within 9 months, without taking even 1 pie, they are able to give me. That is how we are able to do this share. Friends, you are all aware, Amaravati is a beautiful place, historical name. It is a Indra's capital. So, for all gods, Indra is for the ruler. In this background, Amaravati will be the best capital in the world, not the world class. I am very happy MDN CEO has mentioned world class capital. I am not convinced about it. I am talking one among top 5 in the world. That is our concept. 100% I am confident we will make it. With this background, I wanted to present to you very Andhra Pradesh. I want to tell you 4% of India's population and also 8th largest state of India with 13% of India's coastline. As on today, $124 billion economy. But my idea is, I want to take $1 trillion economy, dollar economy, by 2029. If you see here, I, number one in IT, and also electronics, e-governance. We are having 14 ports. Already 6 are in existence. Another 6 ports are developing. 12 airports. Each district one airport, already 6 are in existence, others we are developing in a big way. Last 3 years, our growth rate is 10.5%. Average, double digit growth, this is the first, no other state has grown this type of growth. In spite of new state, so many problems. Even in attracting private investment, we are number one. If you see here, consistently we are growing. First year, 13-14, our growth rate is only 6.96, then 9.20, then 10.60, 11.07, 11.22. In spite of so many hurdles, you are all aware, economy, how it is going in India. Even then, our aim is to grow 15%. I have to grow CAGR 12%, another 15-20 years, to make Andhra Pradesh a developed state. I am confident we will make it. If you see here, All India level 7.18, 7.93, 7.11, 6.60. But our growth rate is consistently, we are moving forward. I am confident this year will cross 12-13%. We have prepared our vision to be among top three developed states in India by 2022, to be the number one state in development and happiness by 2029, and also to become a leading global destination by 2050. For this, if you see, by 2029, $1 trillion economy, per capita income is $16,017, and also accelerating economic growth 12% CAGR, enhancing labor productivity from 4.7 to 16. If you see here, State of the Year award by CNBC, so many awards, among top three states in attracting FDI 2016, first state in e-commerce, e-governance, technology initiatives, around 500 national, international awards our government got. Ours, one of the best team we are having, just like Iora, Bombay Stock Exchange, most efficiently we are dealing. Same thing we are working. We are doing extremely well. Even everywhere people are recognizing us. Ease of doing business, we are number one. I am not satisfied with this. We wanted to be distinct number one, one among top five in the world. Always we want to be top five in the world. That is how we are working in that direction. If you see the Amaravati, this is Amaravati is envisaged to be one of the happiest cities, encompassing the highest standards of livability and infrastructure, with a thriving economic environment. Always I am putting emphasis on happiness. Recently, all over the world, United Nations is doing happiness index. As a matter of fact, India has slipped from 122 to 132. Same time, Andhra Pradesh from 74, we are able to improve 44. Why I am saying, here, always I am talking about happiness. It is a wonderful time for all of us. Why I am saying, technology is a big handy for us. India is very strong in technology. In three areas, if you see, one is India is having demographic dividend, better than America. Compared to America also, we are having large number of English speaking people, and also technology we are very strong. Every four IT professionals, one is an Indian. Among Indians, among four out of four, one is from Andhra Pradesh. That is our strength, core competency and technology. That is the biggest advantage. Even if you see Google, Microsoft, all CEOs from India, even Nadella Satya is from Andhra Pradesh. This is how things are happening. Nowadays, what I am saying, you are seeing Bombay Stock Exchange. Everything, if you imagine, it can be done. That is the advantage present generation is having with technology. Earlier, I promoted information technology for 15-20 years. Because of information technology, Hyderabad has become a knowledge economy. After that, our people have migrated all over the world. If you go to now Silicon Valley, highest per capita income are not Americans or Jewish, but they are from Indians. Among Indians, they are from Andhra Pradesh. Every person is doing extremely well, highest per capita income. Here, today, at that time I promoted information technology. Now data is very important. If there is data, and at the same time, if you can use knowledge with innovation, put it at an information technology platform, and you can produce outcomes. Scale is the matter now. It may be village, it may be mandal.